see what would happen, who is going to come out on top, who is going to win. And this, I guess, can tell us who has the best academy, at least in the last few years. So the way it's going to work is I'm going to do a career mode and then a tournament, so we can, you know, get a fair thing, a fair sort of result here, and we'll see who wins both of those. Now I'm going to control in the career mode Brentford, because as you'll see when I show you everyone's teams, their team's not very good. But anyway, hopefully you find this very interesting. This took quite a long time to, like, transfer and all that, and for certain clubs, like, some players play for multiple academies, so I've kind of just given them to the team that needs them the most, really. And certain clubs didn't have enough players, so I'd, like, let them keep a couple of their current players. But most of the teams were fine. And yeah, now let's go ahead and show you guys every single team and their academy graduates. So, starting off with Arsenal, who have a pretty strong team. They're a team who actually a lot of their current players are in this team, like Saka, Smith Rowe, Eddie Nketiah. They've got two sensational goalies in Wojciech Szczesny and Emi Martinez. Serge Gnabry, some of you may have forgot, that played for Arsenal. Joe Willock, Zinedine Dembélé, Mikel, some of you might remember him. This is definitely a throwback, this video. A lot of these players, I was like, whoa. But yeah, they've got a solid team. Arsenal, they'll be competing for the very top. Bournemouth, yeah, their main man was Danny Ings, who I didn't even realise came through the Bournemouth academy, but they're one of the weaker sides, who were one of those sides who I had to let them keep a couple of their players because they just didn't have enough players, unfortunately. But I mean, it's not the worst side when you compare it to the other teams, because trust me, there are some stinkers in there. But yeah, Danny Ings will be their main man. Aston Villa, they actually have a really nice team, to be honest. Jack Grealish is, of course, back. He is the star man for them. They've got Cameron Archer, Jacob Ramsey, two players who are still at the club. A bit of a throwback with the likes of Barry Bannan and Mark Albright, who were in the academy decades ago, but still knocking about. So yeah, Kieran Clark as well in there. Villa, a pretty solid team. I don't think anything spectacular will happen, but it's a solid team. Brentford, as you can see, not a great team. Yeah, Tariq Mitchell did come from the Palace Academy, but he spent a time in Brentford, so I put him there. And Brentford, of course, don't actually have an academy. They have a B team now, so the other's very, very hard for them. I've tried to make the most of it. But yeah, it's an alright team from Brentford, but not the best. I'm not expecting much from Brentford. Moving on to Brighton, a team who were an interesting one. Again, most of their players now are academy graduates. The likes of Asate, Enzisco, Evan Ferguson, Solly March, Lewis Dunk, the captain, is of course the main man. To be honest, their squad kind of just looks the same to what it is now, really. Ben White is back, which is great for them, but Brighton do actually have a pretty nice team, to be honest. They'll be one to watch. Chelsea, definitely one of the favourites to win this whole thing. Have a stacked team, as we would expect. Interestingly, it seems like we haven't produced a good goalie in a while. I could only find Neil Everidge and Jamal Blackman, but other positions, Tomori, Christensen, James, Ake, Abraham, Mount, Arsenal, so many players there. There was literally about 50 players I could have chosen for Chelsea, so yeah, there's some throwbacks on the bench as well, like Casey Palmer, McEachran, but Chelsea are definitely one of the favourites to win this whole thing. Everton have a really interesting team. They have some players here which I never knew played for them. Shocked them. Mustafi, Stanek and goal, Eric Dyer was a part of the Everton Academy, I'm not sure if you knew that. Yeah, Barkley, Tom Davis, John Lundstrom, interesting midfield pairing there. Pretty average team from Everton. is a solid team. Palace, yeah, not the best team. They've obviously got Zaha back, who is their main man. But apart from him, it's quite poor. Wan-Bissaka is nice. Foderingham in goal is great as well. They were another one of those teams where there was not enough players, so I had to let them keep a couple of their players. But yeah, the thing with Palace, they actually have so many wingers they produce. I was looking, they produce tons of wingers. Other positions, though, they just really struggle to produce them. But yeah, I expect Crystal Palace to struggle a little bit in this one. Fulham have a really, really nice squad, I can't lie. Eze, I think he spent time in Arsenal Academy, but Fulham needed him more, so I put him there. Musa Dembele, striker, Fabio Carvalho, Harvey Elliott, Ryan Sesko, Jed Spence, I didn't know he was at the Fulham Academy. Yeah, I really do like Fulham's team here. It's a really, really fun one, and I think they could be a bit of a dark horse to do something. Burnley, yeah, really, really poor team again. Not much to choose from. And actually with Burnley, I had to give them players who had just been at the club for a long time, like Phil Bardsley, Tarkowski and McNeil. Even though actually McNeil came through the academy, but Tarkowski never came through the Burnley academy, but there were just so little players to choose from. I just had to put some players in there, so that's what I've done with Burnley. Luton, you know what, they have a decent squad. It's actually not that much worse than their real life squad, to be honest, on FIFA. The likes of James Justin, Max Aarons are back at the club, Jamal Lewis. Seems like Luton produce a lot of good fullbacks. Lewis Baker as well in the midfield. Strike position is a bit dodgy. Corley Woodrow is okay, but Musgrave, yeah, not convinced about that. Sheffield United, they have a really, really interesting squad. Aaron Ramsdale, Maguire, Carl Walker, also Calvert-Lewin, some big names there. But then the rest of their squad, you know, the midfield is absolutely horrific. 57 rated and 58 rated, but David Brooks is there. But Sheffield United actually have a pretty decent squad, to be honest. It's almost, you could even argue it's better than their current squad, if you're being honest. Like, they've got some really nice players there, so I expect them to do decent. Liverpool, yeah, I can't lie, Liverpool actually have a pretty bad squad. Their academy has not produced many good players in recent years. Peter Gulaski is one which I never knew came through the academy. Obviously Trent is there, but you know, the front line, they've got Sterling, Suso, but Brewster's the only striker. Cameron Brannigan, that's a throwback. Ben Woodburn, there's a couple decent players in there, but yeah, it's not the greatest team from Liverpool, let's just say that. Moving on to Man City, a team who I would say are probably the most well-rounded out of all of these. There's no real weak spot in this team. Yeah, they've got a lot of players. Kasper Schmeichel, Kieran Trippier is one I never knew played for them. Sancho and Foden on the wings, Angelino left back. They've got a lot of depth. They've just got a load of really solid players, as you would expect. Man City have invested a lot in their academy in recent years, and they will be one of their favourites for this. Their Manchester rivals, United, again, have a pretty balanced team. Paul Pogba is back, Jesse Lingard, Danny Welbeck, Alan Januzaj. There's a lot of players here. Rashford, probably the best one there. It's an interesting squad from United. Solid. I don't think it's incredible, but it's definitely very solid. Again, no real horrible positions, and United will be expecting to do well in this competition. Newcastle, this is their team. Yeah, it's okay. It's not the best, to be honest. Tavernier and Burn, Basham, Adam Armstrong leading the line. Yeah, Newcastle have had a real drop off here, to be honest. Their academy has been pretty poor in recent years in terms of producing players. Not much to choose from. On the wings, it's pretty rough as well, with Diallo on right wing. Nottingham Forest actually have a pretty nice squad, to be honest. Goldalo in goal, Matty Cash right back. They have some really nice centre backs here. Down solid position, 11th for West Ham. Newcastle finished 10th, which is very interesting. A lot better than I expected. Brighton were in 9th. Villa clawed themselves back up into 8th place. A nice second half term. Spurs in 7th. Sheffield finishing the top 6. Level points with Arsenal in 5th. So Sheffield, wow, what a season they had. Arsenal maybe a bit disappointed there to miss out on top 4, but let's see who won the league. It was Man City, but it was very close, only by 2 points. Liverpool, very, very close. Those 2 pulled away from the others. Again, I'm actually really surprised about Liverpool being this high. Chelsea tried to get themselves in a race. I did expect them to do a bit better. United, Arsenal and Sheffield all finished on the same points, so really, really tight between those 2. But there was a major gap from Sheffield to Spurs. So yeah, the top 6 really kind of pulled away from everyone else. But that's pretty interesting. Man City though, RV champions. So they've got their trophy in the bag, but let's go ahead and look at the tournament now. So as I said, the bottom 4 teams will not be added to the tournament. So Brentford, Wolves, Luton and Burnley will be missing out on a spot in the tournament. Now the tournament in terms of structure, we are essentially going to do a like World Cup structure. So it's going to be groups, 4 teams in each group. You play your team one time and then it will just be a one-legged tie all the way up into the final and we'll see who wins it. Now I have to control everyone, but I'm not going to play any of their games. I'm just going to simulate it, so I'm not really getting involved in any of this at all. But yeah, it'll be interesting to see who comes out of this tournament. Will Man City win it as well? And yeah, we'll just like calculate the average if they don't, decide who has actually won this video as a whole. So let's look at the groups. In Group A, we have Nottingham Forest, Brighton, Spurs and Palace. Yeah, probably expect Spurs and Brighton to get out of that group considering how well they did in the league. Group B, Fulham, Newcastle, Everton, Villa. That one's really up for grabs. Probably, yeah, Villa would probably expect to get out of that one. Group C, Arsenal, Bournemouth, Man City, Chelsea. That is a group of death right there. One of the big boys will be going out. Group D, the last group, we have United, Sheffield United, Liverpool, West Ham. Again, a bit of a group of death. Sheffield United, Liverpool United all did pretty well in the league, so it'll be interesting to see who comes out of these group stages. But let's go ahead now and simulate the group stages and let's see the group results. Okay, so the Group A winners were Brighton, and then Nottingham Forest actually came out of the group just ahead of Spurs, and Palace were in last, as kind of expected there. Bit of a shock, Forest out there. Spurs knocked out in the groups, bit of a surprise there, but Brighton top of the group. Group B, Everton top of the group, Newcastle come in second, Fulham third, Villa come last. Again, a bit of a surprise there, considering how well they did in the league. But Newcastle, really a shock here, I can't lie, they really impressed me. Group C, this is probably the biggest shock, so Man City top of the group, Arsenal came out of it, Bournemouth came third, and Chelsea came last without a win. Stunning there. Chelsea finished bottom of a group and knocked out. They have really, really underperformed in this video. And the final group, Liverpool topped of the group, West Ham with another shock here, get out of the group with United and Sheffield United out in the groups. Big, big surprise because both of them were in the top 6. So this is what our quarterfinals are looking like. We have Everton vs West Ham, Liverpool vs Arsenal, Brighton vs Newcastle and Man City vs Nottingham Forest. Some interesting ties in here. Let's see who will be going into the semi-finals. Okay, so here are the results from the quarterfinals. West Ham knockout Everton, Liverpool narrowly defeat Arsenal, Brighton beat Newcastle, and Man City fairly comfortably breeze past Nottingham Forest. Not really any major shocks there, but some potentially be some shocks here, because in the semi-finals we've got Liverpool versus West Ham, and we have Brighton versus Man City. So we could either have the top two facing each other in the final, or West Ham and Brighton, which would be something very, very shocking. Let's have a little look then, simulate these semi-finals and see who makes it to the final of this tournament. Okay, so a bit of a shock here. West Ham have defeated Liverpool. They are going to the final, and unfortunately Man City, no shock for Brighton. Brighton knocked out Man City, have beaten them. So we have a Man City versus West Ham final. West Ham were pretty mid-table in the league, but they've somehow managed to get themselves to the final of this competition. Can they manage to pull off an upset? Let's see. No, they can't, unfortunately. Finished 2-1, Manchester City versus West Ham. And Man City have done it. They have won the tournament. They are the double champs. They won the league in the career mode, and they won the tournament. So, I mean, that makes my life a lot easier in terms of calculating who's won this entire video. Man City have done it. They are the winners of the Academy Graduate Experiment. I guess you can say they have produced the best talents over the last 5-6 years or so. Which, well done to you, Man City and Man City fans. I know I have a couple of you, Daniel, Luke. Hope you guys will accept the trophy of the Academy Graduate Experiment. But I hope you guys have enjoyed this one. If you want more videos like this, then please do let me know. And if you have enjoyed this experiment, please do